some brutal tweets that I sent out last week. A lot of you have seen the vicious text messages that I sent, and I want to let you understand something. Because I said those things, that does not equal me hating James Charles. He has been in my life for a few years now. Are we the best of friends? No. But we had a real connection. I loved and cared about him, and I definitely think I mishandled our friendship, which I will dive into in a minute. But I want to let you guys know that there is no actual hate in this heart. I don't know what the future holds, but I do know that I need to get a few things off my chest. And one of those things is that behind the scenes, there was definitely weird feelings. Everyone over the last few days keeps asking about the Seattle trip, about the text messages, and I really want to let you guys know something. After Seattle, okay, which there are so many rumors, right? Everyone has their own version of the story. We were all there. Today, I am not going to give the world what they want. And I don't think that everyone wants this from me, but I think that there is a major portion that thinks Jeffree Star is going to come for James because I was in a dark place yesterday. I said some things online about pulling receipts and showing things, and I sat there with myself, and I sat there with my mother, and I sat there with Nathan, and we fully understand the power of millions of people watching and what my voice and what this channel actually means to me. And what it means is that I don't want to play the games anymore. I sat there yesterday and I started to get really angry. I was going to pull voice memos. I was going to pull old text messages from other people that don't want to be involved. And I was just getting into a place where it wasn't healthy, okay? And thank God I'm in the headspace that I am today because I stopped those feelings, I let them all subside, and I understand that now that isn't okay. I am not going to fuel this fire bigger so everyone can get more entertainment, because behind the scenes, this isn't funny. This is our real lives, and I inserted myself into something publicly that I shouldn't have. And I think that I need to let you guys know where I'm at today and where I've been this entire year, okay? I am in an amazing place. I'm in a beautiful relationship. My business is amazing. My family is mainly healthy besides my mom. My dogs are healthy. I have amazing employees. I have a good group of people around me. And I think sometimes we slip into our old ways. And today, I know what people want. They want me to sit here and degrade James. They want me to open up my phone and expose it all. I'm done doing that. And it may be shocking. Some of you may be like, oh, are you just trying to save your own ass? Are you a liar? Are you this? I'm willing to bite the bullet and let anyone think what they want. But today I will not be posting voice memos. I will not be posting text messages. I will not be exposing anything more. This has to stop. I'm embarrassed by my own actions. And a lot of you may be like, whoa, what do you mean by that? I could have handled things differently. After Seattle, yes, me and Nate were very uncomfortable with some things that had happened. We were kind of getting distant from James and we really weren't on the same vibe. And that's okay. But what I should have done is vented all my feelings to James. And I know that Tati got to do that. She had private conversations with him. I didn't do that. I should have been mature enough to say, hey, I love and care about you. I've heard X, Y, and Z about you. I've seen some things I didn't like. Here's my feelings. But guess what? I didn't. And that was my first mistake. I want to give you guys some context. I don't want you to see things that I've written to someone and think, wow, like Jeffree is an evil person. He's a bitch. I want to let you guys know that there is a big piece of the story that I don't think a lot of people know. And that's that behind the scenes, there were people in my head. There were people telling me a lot of stuff. And I don't mean my own friends. I mean people that had known James. They were being very, I don't know the right word, but they were telling me things that was making me feel a whole other way. Should I have let other people get in my head and sway my opinion about someone? No, that's my problem. And I have to deal with that. I have let people get in my head for years. I have let others and their opinions somehow get to me. So moving forward, I want to handle things